गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर अंडरस्टैंडिंग एलिमेंट्री शेप्स। इन दिस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मेजर ऑफ एंगल, हाउ टू मेजर ऑफ एंगल, हाउ कैन वी फाइंड आउट दैट हाउ मच एंगल इज फॉर्म्ड बिटवीन एनी टू आर्म्स। सो इन दिस सी एंगल हाउ टू मेजर दैट सपोज वी टेक दिस वन रे ओपी and we rotate this line like this, firstly OP, OP1, OP2, OP3 like this, then how much it arms is open, this is called the magnitude of an angle. And one thing remember, magnitude of an angle doesn't depend on the length of the arms. What is the meaning of it? See, suppose I take this one angle, there are two arms OP and OP1. Doesn't matter that OP, P point here, this one open or this one open. These both show the same magnitude of the angle. How much open between two arms? This is called the magnitude of an angle. What is the length of arm for it? That we take till here and till one here, till here. Then doesn't depend on the length of the arms. How much we are opening the sides or arms of an angle, this is called the magnitude of an angle. Now see in this, I'll start from here, OP. Firstly, I rotate till here, OP1, then OP2, OP3, OP4. So this type angle changes. From starting ray, and when a complete rotation means you start just from OP and ends also to OP, then take after taking a complete revolution, then it makes an angle 360 degree. See now, in this measure of an angle, this circle part, this one part divided into angle of 360 degree. See, you start from here 0 degree. After this, each part is divided into 10 degree. 10 degree arc, and this 10 degree arc also you can divide it into 10 parts. But this one angle, if I want to show, this becomes very small. So we take the gap of 10 degree. If you see properly, after when it reach at 90 degree, it complete 1/4 part, quarter part we can say. When it complete from this half part or 180 degree, then it complete half part. Until 270 degree, then 3/4 part of rotation done. And complete 360 degree, it means one complete revolution it will take. Okay, now see. What is given to you in your book? Degree measure of an angle, it means each circle is divided into 360 equal part. So what is the value of one part? That become 1/360. One part or one small division value in the circle, we can say that is equal to 1/360. And degree is denoted by this sign. There is no, if I write down this like this, I read as 1 degree. So this is the symbol of the degree. Now see, your question is, what is the measure of the arc from 0 to 20? In this circle, if rotation held, then what is the value of this angle? Obviously 20 degree. What fractional part? It means 20 degree. What is the measure of the arc from 0 to 20? What fractional part of the circle is the 90 degree or arc from 0 to 90? When it moves from 0 to 90 degree, then this part is the 1/4 part of the circle. In a fraction, we can say 1/4 part of the circle. Until 180, then it is the half part of the circle. Is a 180 degree arc half of the circle? Yes, this one is right. Now see, there are given to you simple table that if second ray also here, then it makes 0 degree. This one is 90 degree, 1/4 part. 2 rays like this. Then this is 180 degree. Two 70 degree, that we can say 3/4 part. Again here one complete revolution, it means 360 degree. So this time we will describe, we will find out the value of measure of an angle. Now this system, measure of an angle, in everyday we will see the clock. We always see the clock and discuss. Now today we will discuss about the clock. See here, we know that in this clock we have minute hand, hour hand, second hand. Clock is divided into 12, 3, 6, 9, 12. This 3, it means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It means in our end, we can say, this clock, this circle is divided into 12 equal parts. And one complete revolution is equal to 360 degree. It means in 1 hour, how many degree it will take? In 12 hour, hour end take 360 degree. Then in 1 hour, 360 divided by 12, that is equal to 30 degree. Later we will discuss more. This time we are discussing only in minute hand. Will making 3 o'clock. This one is hour hand and this one is minute hand. Then it will show 3 o'clock, and if you see properly, this is 1/4 part of the clock. If this hour hand come here, rotate from here, then it will take half part of the circle. It means we can say it will make 180 degree. And if it will be here, then 3/4 part. You can see easily that we are moving in a clockwise direction. And this one again, then it will make one complete revolution, that is 360 degree. And this is a clockwise direction. If you move from here, then it will call counterclockwise direction. Now see, there is given to you rotation round the clock. 90 degree quarter past, 180 degree half past, 270 degree quarter to, 270 degree and one round complete is equal to 360 degree. Now your question, according to this, how many minute divisions are there on a clock face? Minute divisions कितने होते हैं clock face में? You know that between 12 and 1 there are 5 parts. 60. How many divisions are here for the minute hand? There is a 60 parts. Second question is, how many minutes are there from 12 to 1? 12 to 1 ke beech mein kitne minutes hai? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minutes. Because there are 5 divisions. What is the measure of the angle of minute hand has turned through in moving from 12 to 1? जब ये 12 to 1 तक मेजर मूव कर रही है मिनट हैंड, तो वो कितने डिग्री का एंगल बनाएगी? पहले मिनट हैंड यहाँ थी, यहाँ से अगर वो 30 डिग्री वन मिनट वन आवर पर मूव कर रही है, तो वो कितना एंगल बनाएगी? देर आर टोटल हाउ मेनी पार्ट्स? 60 पार्ट्स. सी इन 60 पार्ट्स व्हेन इट विल मूव देन इट विल मेक 360 डिग्री. देन वन पार्ट देन 360 by 60, that is equal to 6 degree. In 12 to 1, how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. It means, sorry, for the 5 part, it will take how many degree? 30 degree. We can say in the minute hand, if we want to find out the degree per minute, then our formula becomes 6 multiplied by minute. That 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 12 to 1, there are 5 minutes. It means 6 multiplied by 5, that is equal to 30 degree. So, this time we will solve these questions. In the next lecture, we will discuss more about clock. Okay, student. Now, in the next lecture, we will discuss about the directions and more about the clock. Thank you.